impression is really very good because this is the first time I'm attending also this inaugural summit, you know, between my continent, Africa, and the Americas. And I think this is a very good initiative because the African Union has been engaged with a lot of partnership. And I think the common issues that we have, mostly in this important sector, which is agriculture, we have common problems. And I think it's good to bring synergy and work together, create a platform, institutionalize this platform with the African Union Commission, because it is the African Commission that is the federation that federates all intergovernmental organizations. When minister comes, being political, you know, the only way or port of entry of any outcome that comes out from this type of gathering is through the African Union. Then it becomes, you know, a continental strategy, and then we can mobilize funds and follow up track programs. So I think it's a very good initiative. The African Union Commission is really stands for having a cooperation, maybe an MOU with this important institution, ICA, so that we will continue, you know, to elaborate upon the decision and the recommendation that is coming out. Because what we want today is action. We don't want just to come for a meeting and then we leave. There's a lot of investment, paying tickets, all this. So we need to deliver because the world is really suffering in this sector. So if we bring, we come all together, you know, with our brothers from the Americas, from Latin America and Caribbean, I think that is the way forward. That is a good coordination that we encourage it and that we are going to follow it up. The most salient sort is to combat the food insecurity and malnutrition on the both continents. Because when you look at the statistics, they are informing us how serious this situation is, both in Africa and also here in Latin America. So I think that we need to really mitigate, first of all, the food insecurity on the continent. We know the cause, we know some shocks and causes that are causing it. Like in Africa, it's more conflict. We have conflict, we have climate change. So we need to really look at how we can create a resilient, you know, a sustainable, resilient agri-food system so that our population can have access, affordable, you know, healthy food for them to consume. We know that food is life. Without food, you cannot have a human capital. You cannot develop. So it's as serious as a peace and security as well. So I think we need to address this issue. The sooner, the better. Africa has an advantage to have 60 to 65 uncultivated arable land globally. So only that we have the arable land. So this is one of the, you know, the assets. The second asset, Africa is the region that has the youngest population. 60% of our population are young. So we have a human capital, we have a dividend, we have to really tap that dividend that we have of human capital. Half Africa has seas, we have lakes, we have rivers, we have the hydrometric is very, very important. So this is another capital we have. And Africa has good weather. Africa has good weather to produce food. So it is inadmissible that in our continent, we are net importer of food. So $45 billion yearly is invested on food. I think we need to stop it. And we really need to give priority. We are just coming from our mid-year coordination summit in Lusaka. And our head of state, they have given us guidance. They say, if you look at the lesson learned from the pandemic COVID-19, and now today with the Russia and Ukraine crisis, Africa should go through food sovereignty. We need to be really, sufficient, feed our food population and have autosufficiency in the area of food. So talking about food sovereignty is no longer just a word, but it is a must for the continent. If we want to transform and if we want to really, feed our people so that people will come out of hunger and poverty. From what we can see today during the throughout our conversation, the issue of science, science, technology, and innovation was highly highlighted. And I believe that you have a comparative advantages comparing to us in Africa. So that is an area where we really can cooperate so that all is a good example, good lesson, and technical assistance getting from this part of this region. It's very important for us, because when you look at Brazil with all this innovation they're doing here too, you know, so I think it's a very good, and there are a lot of similarity, even in terms of weather. So I think this is an area that we would really like to take advantage in this partnership we are signing. It's very important. And also the issue related to the climate change. There's a lot of experience here, because you have experience. Most of your countries, mostly island countries, you have cyclone, you have all this, and you know how to mitigate it. So I think we can share experience also from this region that is really highly hit by cyclones, floods, and the constant fire burn on the forest. And then when you come to Costa Rica, you see how green it is. So nature-based solution can also be one of the aspects, because we, after the COVID-19 pandemic, we elaborated an initiative that we call GRAP, the African Union Green Recovery Action Plan. And one of the pillars, the five pillars, we have five pillars. One of the pillar is really nature-based solution for the forest. You know that Africa has the second biggest forest after the Amazon, and it plays a very good service to the planet. So we want to really conserve our biodiversity and our forest, and also the water. You know, we want to really know how to manage water, you know, clean water, so that we will avoid a lot of diseases for the public health for our population.